We left off last week with Fred Korematsu having lost his battle against the Supreme Court for unlawful internment of Japanese Americans after the attack on Pearl Harbor. A loss that he considered to be tantamount to legalized racism. A loss that proved America only loved those citizens whose faces fit. He took the loss of the trial so deeply that Fred delved into a life of anonymity, shying away from interviews and attention so that he could focus on rebuilding his life and healing the wounds left over from the court case and the internment. He married and moved from Detroit to California, back to his birthplace of Oakland in the late 1940s, and lived a normal, unassuming life. That was until one day in 1967, when a young girl found out about Fred's story and confronted him. This would start Fred on a path that would finally see him break his anonymity and silence after 30 years and start the journey, once again, to right the wrongs done to him. A journey that would eventually make a government capitulate and finally bring justice to Fred and the other 120,000 Japanese Americans. This is Dark Side, and I am your host, Suze.